I mean everyone, including elected officials. It has been more than 180 days since the legislature last met. Instead, they have spent their time in the courts trying to thwart every state effort to keep Wisconsinites healthy and safe. And time again, we've heard that Republican legislators just want a seat at the table. I've been sitting here at this table, which is the same place I've sat about once a week for months now, and I have yet to hear any ideas, plans, or solutions. Last week, we learned the Republicans in the legislature plan to come in and vote down our statewide COVID-19 public health emergency and our order requiring face coverings in public places. Not only that, but that they intend to wait to take that vote until after Election Day. Folks, that's just not right. First and foremost, in light of the near exponential increase in cases, rising hospitalization rates, and the beginning of cold and flu season, ending our public health emergency in the midst of a global pandemic would have serious consequences for our state. But regardless, Wisconsinites deserve to know where their elected leaders stand on these critically important issues. I've sent legislators a letter asking them just that, sharing my concerns about their plan, and once again, inviting Republican leaders to meet. I'm hopeful that they will put their ideas and feedback and plans to paper so that we can urgently address the challenges facing our state. Because here's the bottom line for me, Wisconsin families and frontline healthcare workers, businesses, farmers, hospital systems, and folks across our state deserve to know sooner rather than later whether our state will once again be thrown into chaos as a result of yet another Republican effort to prevent us from keeping people safe. So today, I'm encouraging every Wisconsinite to contact their state senators and state representatives and ask them whether they support our state's public health emergency, whether they support requiring face coverings in public places like 72% of Wisconsinites, and whether they believe the legislature should come in for a vote in advance of the November election. You can find your legislator's contact information by typing in your address at lagis.wisconsin.gov. So with that, I will now turn things over to Secretary Designee Andrea Palm for her updates on the COVID-19 in Wisconsin. Andrea.
Thanks, Governor. Good afternoon, everyone, and thanks for joining us again today. I do want to start with the numbers today because I want to make sure that we're all tracking on the magnitude of the challenge that we're facing here in Wisconsin. There are now 155,471 confirmed cases of COVID-19, which is an increase of 3,279 from yesterday. Our 7-day average of new daily cases is 2,727, which is up from 1,141 one month ago. We saw a record number of deaths today, with 34 more Wisconsinites losing their lives. Our total deaths have now reached 1,508. Our hearts go out to the families who have lost loved ones to COVID-19. Tomorrow, the alternate care facility at the Wisconsin State Fair Park will open. It's ready to accept COVID-19 transfer patients from Wisconsin hospitals. The facility is prepared to accept up to 50 patients on its first day, and we will scale that capacity as needed. A multidisciplinary clinical team is ready to serve patients, including doctors, nurses, social workers, pharmacists, and other medical staff. Our current surge in cases will lead to more hospitalizations, which is why we must be prepared. As the governor said, we hope we do not need this overflow capacity, but the reality of this virus, its transmissibility, its incubation time, and its potential severity dictates that we get ready. So as we work at the state level with our healthcare and public health partners to provide testing, tracing, and treatment, we need everyone in Wisconsin to work at the individual, family, and community level to help stop the spread. Stay home as much as you can. If you can work from home, please do. Limit your errands to the essentials as much as you can. Yes, get your groceries and go to the pharmacy, but please cancel the dinner parties and the happy hours. Wear a mask because your mask protects me and my mask protects you. Remember to stay 6 feet apart from other people. Masks are an effective tool, but they are most effective when we all do it and when we combine it with other actions, like practicing physical distancing and washing our hands frequently. If you have symptoms or have been exposed to COVID-19, please get tested. Call your healthcare provider or visit one of our community testing sites. Then be sure to quarantine. Self-isolate if you get a positive result, and while you await the call from a contact tracer, reach out to your close contacts and ask them to do the same. And please, get a flu shot. It's more important this year than ever. The flu shot can't prevent a COVID-19 infection, but by preventing a flu infection, it can help you stay healthy and preserve our hospital capacity. These are steps we can all take to stop the spread and protect ourselves and each other.